Just a few weeks ago, we posted a video about the MagSafe charging comparison between iPhone 13 Pro Max and 14 Pro Max. And some audiences are more curious about the MagSafe charging performance of the entire iPhone 14 series. So today we'll run some tests for every model to see their differences. First, let's review the wired charging test we did before. The peak power of the iPhone 14 Pro Max and iPhone 14 Plus is the highest, which can be close to 27 watts. The 14 Pro and 14 have lower charging power, which is around 22 to 25 watts, because of the smaller heat dissipation space. Back to our today's topic, the MagSafe charging. We choose the Apple 35 watts traditional charger to do the test. Connect it to the power ZKM002C, and we can see that the no-load power consumption is about 0.3 watts. Since MagSafe is a type of wireless charging, the measured power is higher than the actual power received by iPhone. Starting with iPhone 14, the voltage is 9 volts, and we have to be patient, because it takes some time for the power to gradually increase from 11 watts to a stable 18 watts. And the iPhone 14 Pro is almost the same as the iPhone 14. The peak power is about 18 watts. The iPhone 14 Plus is bigger, so the power can be up to 19 watts. And the same 19 watts can also be seen on iPhone 14 Pro Max due to its larger size. After briefly testing the charging power of those four models, let's try to charge them fully. Starting with iPhone 14, the voltage is very stable at 9 volts, and the power fluctuated between 6 to 19 watts. At 1 hour and 4 minutes, the power jumped to 7 watts and lasted until 1 hour and 30 minutes. After that, the power gradually dropped to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 52 minutes to be fully charged. Moving on to iPhone 14 Pro, the voltage is also stable at 9 volts. The power fluctuated between 10 to 18 watts in the first hour, and then the power jumped to around 7 watts and lasted until 1 hour and 25 minutes. After that, the power gradually dropped to almost zero. The total charging time is 1 hour and 53 minutes, almost the same as 14. Next, the iPhone 14 Plus. The voltage is still stable at 9 volts, and the power is stable at 18 watts for the first 5 minutes. Like the other two models, the power begins to fluctuate between 11 to 16 watts. At 1 hour and 60 minutes, the power gradually drops to 10 watts. After 1 hour and 38 minutes, the power gradually drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 25 minutes to be fully charged. Finally, the iPhone 14 Pro Max. Voltage is the same, 9 volts. And the power is stable at 18 watts for the first 17 minutes. Then the power begins to fluctuate between 11 to 18 watts. At 1 hour and 5 minutes, the power gradually drops to 9 watts. After 1 hour and 29 minutes, the power gradually drops to almost zero. The total charging time is 2 hours and 13 minutes, 12 minutes faster than 14 Plus. We also draw some curves for you to compare their differences intuitively. The champion is definitely the iPhone 14, but is only 1 minute faster than the 14 Pro, and the iPhone 14 Plus is the slowest. The reason why the bigger models take more time to be fully charged is that it has a larger battery capacity. The battery capacity of 14 and 14 Pro is around 3200 mAh, and the capacity of 14 Plus and 14 Pro Max is about 4300 mAh. Compared with the wired charging test, like the iPhone 14 Pro, it only needs 1 hour and 39 minutes to be fully charged when charging with a cable, which is about 14 minutes faster. Well, that's all MagSafe charging tests we made for iPhone 14 series. We found that MagSafe charging is not as slow as we might think. It's just less stable than wired charging under different conditions. But we believe this must be a solid step for Apple to move forwards to a portless iPhone. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to see other videos related to MagSafe. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!